Hello guys, this is Rahul here from myview.rahullevy.net, which is my blog. Here in this screencast, we'll be continuing from the last two sections. In the very first section, we have seen how to configure your workspace as Visual Studio Code right from the beginning. In the second screencast, we have seen how to get started with Angular 2 setup, right? There are certain prerequisites which was required to get started with Angular 2 development, right? So we have already seen these two screencasts. Now in this section, we'll be starting with some of the basics of Angular 2, right? So it's pretty much the same, as far as basics are concerned from Angular 1, it gets started with modules, right? So modules are nothing but I would say it's a kind of namespace in terms of C# or something, or Java, any object-oriented language, or I would say it's a kind of container to isolate the things or isolate the features. It's pretty much designed on the lines of dependency injection. So whatever component is required, you can just bring in over in that app, and you can utilize its features to boost your app, to write a pretty robust app. So in the coming sections, which we'll be seeing that services and directives, some structural directives, and the new features which we have, which Angular team has introduced, right? So in this section, let's talk about some of the things which we have done in the previous screencast, components and all, right? So rather than doing the slides, right? So I would rather prefer to explain the same thing in editor itself. So let's see, first of all, how any app gets bootstrapped, right? So this was the thing which we have, created in the last section, right? So if I simply run this app, then it will simply produce the simple page which is saying my first Angular 2 movie review app, right? And let's say this you like to do certain changes over here, right? And you first of all would like to understand how this is getting bootstrapped. The very first thing is it's getting imported from over here. If you see that line number 17, right, which I am highlighting, so you can see here it's getting bootstrapped from here, and it is from here it's going to the main.ts. so this is the component which is bootstrapping our feature actually. So before looking into this, let's look at our component.ts file. So what this import is doing, import is actually importing the required component from cloud, I would say rather from your machine itself, because we have already because we have already installed all the node modules which is required for Angular 2, right? So it's basically importing the features from Angular library and putting it in here. And this add component is nothing but a decorator, right, which is adding some of the features inside it. This will act as a metadata inside the page which is getting rendered finally. So this will have that entire logic inside which needs to be emitted in that index.html page. Now this entire thing is getting exported via this class, right? This export class we are exporting over here. And in this previous page which I was talking is this main.ts. so this main.ts is nothing but is your bootstrapper. So it's the main entry point for your application, right? So how it is happening is this is the bootstrap component which it is in, again borrowing from Angular library. It's just feeding here in this app, right? And then app component, it is taking this app component is nothing but our class, this one, right? And it is importing from that app.component file itself, right? And this bootstrap function is actually bootstrapping our app. So this is how it happens. And this is the small snippet which I've written is just to log our successful instance or something messed up, that particular thing over here, right? Now let's see this guy. If I come here in the previous thing, it is actually emitting one selector. So my dash app, right? So, and with that, this HTML markup with an H1 tag, right? So if I see this index page, now this my app. So this is getting emitted over here from that metadata itself, right? So it doesn't mean this HTML element is actually HTML element. This is customized by us, right? So we have created this custom element only for this particular app. It's if I say simply, let's say my app and Rahul, and let's say what happens here. All right, just save this, it gets put. Now here it error came, right? So if I just my preferred window is this one. If I just, so it threw error over here, right? So you can see this, right? So my app didn't match any elements, right? Because the thing is, it's getting emitted as my app, and I'm expecting over here my app underscore my app Rahul, right? So let me go this and undo this change. Now save this. Now everything is working as simple as it is, right? Now there is there are a few things which I wanted to talk about is like let's say there are certain components. This is pretty much that static thing which is coming handy with your quick start HTML, right? Now if you like to optimize and make it more modular, because you won't be preferring this guy like this HTML element here in that main.ts, if you see here, not in main dot component.ts, right? Like you are emitting this templates like this one, and you are just feeding there in that index page, right? So it is not pretty much preferable thing. This is just good to get started with that, but I would suggest you to get started with this guy, Angular cheat sheet, right? So Angular cheat sheet you can find here in Angular.io site itself. This is being provided by Google team with this cheat sheet URL, and here you can see this very handy tricks which is oftenly used while building this any app, Angular 2 app. So all the with template syntax and what are the requirements, like what are the components that is required with template syntax and with the reasoning, like what it is doing, right? And here you can see like in the basic sections on the left hand side with that implementation of all with some examples, some working examples. So let's say I am inside this decorator, right? So what kind of decorator could be like? So it's saying that these are the class decorators, directive decorators, pipe, injectables, and what could be the configurations. Like, let's say I am inside this decorator of this first of all this component decorator itself, right? So this can have template URL, styles URLs. Let's see another piece which I have done for that only. So here is like my app component.ts, right? So here you can see is my selector is my app only, but here I am using template URL, a different syntax over here to include that my HTML file. So my HTML file is this one. So this entire div section is my HTML file. Here I am using material design. As you can see here is MTL layout. So that's okay. That's not in the scope of this this section, because material design will be discussing in some other screencast. But for now, that's okay. So this is just emitting my HTML file over here from that template URL, and then it is also including my component.css, so which is here, and again it is emitting that app component. So if I go to my index page over here, here I have certain assets folder as well, which is related to my material design itself with my small icon, which is here. So if I just run this guy, let's just stop this first. If I just run this guy, So here it came. Like you can see here, there's a small little icon which is saying Movie Review App and by Rahul Sahai, and everything is like Welcome to Movie Review App using Angular Joomla. So this looks pretty good, like I mean pretty presentable. Similar thing, but little bit of isolation, a little bit of improvisation in the existing piece. Like now in the next screencast we'll be delving further, right? And we'll be doing certain more experiments around these components and the classes which we are exposing. Let me discuss one more feature before wrapping up this module. Let's say this is my thing, my existing component here. And let me go to this index page itself. And here, if you see this guy, app, this is how it is getting bootstrapped. And if I do this kind app main, this will also take the same effect and it will launch the same thing. So let me close this. Now launch. All right. Now let's say you don't want to keep the name as main itself, right? You like to have certain other things, like let's say main one and main two or something, entry point. So this is effective basically for that kind of scenario. So you like to rename this and then compile that thing into that, then it is effective in that. But if you only keep this apps, then by default it will keep take as app, and it would expect that main to be as main.js in that index.html file, which is actually getting emitted. Otherwise it will throw 404 error. So I hope you have enjoyed this video. In the coming sections, which we will see, we will delve further into components, templates, stylings, directives, and many more other features. Till then, stay tuned. Happy coding.